I find myself not exporting the PDFs and DXFs from the tablet anymore. We don't need to email the jobs to ourselves or do any of those kinds of things or use a thumb drive. This really is much, much easier. And this is what our customers have been asking for. I'm going to just come up from loading the job. Let's go into file and save the job to folder. And we get this screen. I've zoomed in a little, so this should be easier to read the text. By default, you might have a whole bunch of these options checked on. And for many of our users, that's just going to be too many outputs. So let's talk about these for a minute. The LT3 job file. This is going to take the place, if you used our old software, the classic Laser Templater app, this replaces the L55 file. If I'm measuring, I export this, so I always have a snapshot of the work that I did, and I save it in case I ever need it. I probably won't, though, right? If I come to PDF, these are all of the PDFs that I might print out, okay, or send to a customer. I like the shop sheets quite a bit. We think of a shop sheet as all of the essential information that's needed on your shop floor and in the office and by the installers. This won't have every single piece of information, but should have the most essential. Right? Individual shop sheets. This one's a little different. If I have multiple pages, like I do in this job, I would get an individual PDF file, one for each page. The standard shop sheet, the one that I use most often personally, and most of our fabricators use, you would get one PDF file that has, in this case, all five drawing pages. Again, most shops use this one, and they do not use the individual shop sheet layout. Nesting layout. If you've done a nest, it'll create a PDF render of how those parts fit in that size slab. Most of the time, I turn this off. It's only once in a while that I need that export. The job manifest. I turn this on because I think it's really handy. It's another document that is especially helpful for the installers. They can count their parts. They can load up their A-frames each day. And it's a really clean way to keep your job. And if you have a lot of production, a lot of parts flying around the shop, keep everything organized. It literally puts all the same pieces in the same orientation, auto-dimensioned on the page. If I'm working with remodel customers especially, but in general, if I have a customer agreement, I'm going to export it. Okay. Photos. Now, there's a difference between photos here. That's going to be in the PDF. Photos down here, this will just spit out JPEGs on their own. I find that the photos in PDF is much more useful because I have any notes on my photos and it shows the photo attached to the measure page if I had done that during the measure. It's just really useful. That's my favorite way to go. The next one I want to talk about is the job packet. If we select job packet, on the next screen, I get another option. Template summary, general notes, page notes. All of these would be combined into one large PDF. This is often sent to the customer with all of these in one easy to read file. Again, we'd see the shop sheets, we'd see the job manifest, the agreements, the notes, all that stuff all together. Okay, I'm gonna hit back, turn this off. If we hit next, you notice it jumped over that last screen. Okay. Totally up to you if you need that file. If you have job packet and shop sheets, and let's say you had individual shop sheets, you would get duplicate shop sheets in your exports. That's confused a few users, so I wanted to take a moment to talk about how that works. I generally turn that off for me. I'm usually just communicating directly with the shop. And again, this one's useful if you have a document you want to send directly to a customer for their contract and their approvals, okay? Now, last but not least, this is really important, your CAD CAM files. These are your DXF or DWG files. Do I want my template drawing pages? That's the first one. If I did any nesting, that'd be this one. If I did a CNC saw page is just a quick cleanup of your job. It does some of that kind of CAD prep work for us. I tend to turn those on as needed. Now, if I'm someone that just takes templates that were just done from the field, and it's my job to just revise quotes, do the paperwork, that way customers can approve that, I would then turn this off. I just want documentation. I'd probably stay up here. If I am programming or doing CAD prep, I need this and I may not need these. So I want to talk about that difference as well. If you're a bigger team, you have different individuals doing programming of machines and different individuals managing the accounts or managing those jobs, they're going to live in different areas on this export screen. Okay. I would hit next, check any boxes for any pages. If I have a single page, and in this case, the little diamond shape you see here, the little three diamonds, that shows that I did a nest for this page. Okay, that's what this little symbol means, right? I do want to export all these pages. Let's hit next. If I wanted to export the layout as well, I'd hit next. This is where they go. When we hit next, it will render our PDFs, save our DXFs. And again, this is typically going to be faster on a desktop, more powerful computer that's not designed to save battery life as much as your Surface computer is, right? There's actually a lot of work the computer's doing. Here's the folder for my job. Inside the CNC folder, I'd have the CNC saw layout if I did that. Here's our DXFs for each of the drawing page. Shop sheets, right? I've got one file has multiple pages. Okay, let's close that. Our manifest. This is a document our customers just love. It shows the drawing page, and I see each of the parts in that page. If I had a support bar that was needed for that, we see on this manifest, again, the thumbnail, the page, and all the parts. This is a new output that fabricators really enjoy. And then I have our LTC file. This is our laser template collection. This is the project file for LT3 Raptor templates and the exports. Okay, so that's an overview of all the different kinds of things we can export. We think this is going to be helpful as you do your work. Thank you.